Brian Laird. I serve here as the chairman of the Elder Board. And with me today is my good friend and co-laborer in Christ, Roger McCoy, who serves as our lead operations pastor.
Thank you, Brian, and good morning, church family.
If you want to take a seat, this will only take a couple minutes. Harvest family, today is the day that we have been praying and fasting for. And in fact, on April 14th, when the elders called the church to prayer and fasting, God moved and answered our prayers in an amazing way. So today is an exciting day for our church.
That's right, Brian. With thanks and praise to our great Lord, I'm very excited to say that today the Harvest family gets to hear that we have selected our new lead teaching pastor. Come on.
That's right.
Come on.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
So quickly, before you get to actually hear from him, we the elders just wanted to express that this search process has been about our dependence and our trust in the Lord. And through that, we have seen the Lord confirm our pillar of prayer. We believe firmly in the power of prayer and our God who answers our prayers. We are also thankful for the many men who have served in this pulpit over the last couple of years. Men like Dave Stone, Pastor Tommy, Pastor Jeff, Pastor Eddie Hoagland, Dr. V, and our own Dr. Rodelnik, who was just up here.
Yes.
And there's so many others. And through their faithful service to the Lord and his word, our God has actually given us a great gift because he has shown us that it is he who sustains his church. Preaching God's word faithfully, which is also one of our pillars, is what he is concerned with.
Amen. Amen. I also would like to share with you that both the selection committee and the lay elders were unanimous in their decision to call this man to come lead our church. But that's enough from us. If you'll turn your attention to the screen, you will meet our new lead teaching pastor, Dr. Jeff Bucknam, and his wife, Jeannie.
Hi, my name is Jeff Bucknam, and this is my wife, Jeannie, and we are thrilled to say that we are going to be the next, I'm going to be the next lead teaching pastor at Harvest Bible Chapel. I'm super excited to come there because of the challenge that it is, to be honest with you, and the potential and how amazing it has been in the past. And my desire actually to train leaders and to see churches planted and that kind of thing is exactly what Harvest has been about for so many years. It's very much what I'm about. It's what I've been about for a lot of years in the ministries that I've been doing. And so we're just super, super thrilled that we were chosen to do this, to be honest with you. We're really blessed by it. We've had a very interesting last number of months as I've been in a conversation with the search committee and the elders and that. We made one clandestine trip to Chicago, and it was fantastic. And so we're at a point now, we're really excited that we get to be a part of the ministry there. God really has moved in our lives to bring us to this point, and it's been kind of hard, but kind of great. Why has it been kind of hard though?
It's just been a process. We have three kids that are, our oldest son is 20, our second son, Micah, is 17, and our daughter is 11. So it's just a stage of life, I think, that is hard to consider making a transition. Our boys are at a stage where they have had to consider whether they're coming with us, whether they wouldn't be coming with us, and that's been a challenge for me. But God has been moving in our hearts, I think, just warming our hearts to the idea, warming their hearts to the idea of being willing to serve him wherever he calls. And that's been a really, actually, beautiful journey for my family, for our kids, just to think about what discipleship looks like and following whatever God calls us to do. So, yeah.
We had gotten to the point, actually, that if Harvest had said no to us, we would have been heartbroken, to be honest. So we're really, really excited about it. We've been here, right now we're in just outside of Vancouver, British Columbia. We've been here for the last 15 years. Prior to that, we were in New Zealand for 7, and prior to that, we lived in the United States for all the rest of our days prior to that. And so we have a really weird story. Like, all of our kids are Americans, all of our kids are Canadians, and two of them are New Zealanders. So it's difficult to go through borders. But yeah, we just want to serve the Lord with you, and we want to do the very best we can to serve you and to love you. And the pillars that the church are built upon are things that we share very much and have been committing our lives and our ministry to for all these years in the past. So look, we're really looking forward to being a part of ministry there and seeing you in May. I'm preaching two times in May and then coming on staff in July. But we're really looking forward to all the great things that are to come. So thanks so much. We'll see you very, very, very soon.
Thank you.
Yeah, what an exciting day. What an exciting day. So as Pastor Jeff said, he's going to be here the last two Sundays in May to preach in person, and then back July the 12th when he officially starts. In the meantime, we'll keep you updated through normal communications. You can also reach out to your campus pastor or elder. And additionally, we'll be updating the website, so you'll find some really good updates soon at harvestbiblechapel.org/search.
So lastly, the elders just want to say that they're thankful for the search team and all the hard work that they put in, meeting so many candidates, narrowing it down to two, and then ultimately one. Their hard work and sacrifice is what brought us to today. But most importantly, we want to thank and praise the Lord Jesus Christ, who has been sustaining Harvest Bible Chapel. We are seeing him do a mighty work here, and we are so excited for the future. So will you join me right now as we just pray and thank the Lord? Heavenly Father, Lord, we are so thankful for you. We are so thankful for the message today from Dr. Rudelnik. Lord, we're so thankful to see baptisms in our church. And Lord, we just come before you right now and we celebrate and we praise you for what you have been doing. Lord, we just want to first lift up Northview, Jeff's current church, Lord. They are going to be told the same thing this morning. And so, Lord, they will have, as much as we are excited, they will have sadness to miss their wonderful dear pastor. And so we just pray for them as they go through their transition time. Lord, we pray for the Bucknams as they get ready to move and find a new house and just move their lives. And Lord, we pray specifically for their children, Ethan, Micah, and Sophie, as they go through the changes they have to do. And then lastly, Lord, we lift up Harvest to you. Lord, we still have to embrace Jeff and get to know him, and that's the exciting and fun things. And so, Lord, we just pray that you continue to have your hand on us. Lord, will you just bless us? Bless us as we go forth today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. As you go out, please, and over the coming weeks, please keep Pastor Jeff and Jeannie and their family in prayer as they make a pretty big move in answer to God's calling. And remember, you are loved.